Is this the future of last mile transportation in big cities? In Estonia, unmanned delivery robots sharing the road with passenger vehicles is no longer science fiction.
Our vision is to have an electric unmanned vehicle that doesn't really produce any CO2.
In recent years, Estonia has become the place where the rubber hits the road for autonomous driving tech. The latest unmanned innovation isn't confined to sidewalks or pre-programmed routes. The domain of the Clevon 1 delivery vehicle is on the road. Estonian startup CoModule was one of the world's first business customers to receive a parcel from an unmanned teleoperated delivery robot last year.
Until now, we have received our parcels the most traditional ways, using couriers who bring them up by vans, big trucks. And this is the first time that we have used a robot.
CoModule, itself a mobility company, currently receives up to 10 parcels in 2 to 3 deliveries this way per week. They say reducing emissions is the prime benefit of unmanned electric parcel delivery.
The receiving parcel with Clevon 1 was extremely satisfying because the pollution rate is really low when you're using robots and electrical vehicles. As we are receiving mainly small parcels in CoModule, then in the future, this is something that we will definitely be using only.
Clevon says its autonomous vehicles can one day reduce last mile labor costs by 80 to 90%. Moreover, the EV is tailpipe emission free. A Clevon 1 is about half the size of a typical delivery van. It only weighs 320 kilograms when empty. In 2020, Clevon became the first company in Europe with a permit to operate unmanned vehicles on public roads. According to Clevon, the vehicles have since clocked over 40,000 kilometres. Buyers get to customise the colours of their vehicles.
So Estonia has been the testbed where we have managed to, you know, show the world that that unmanned vehicles are a safe delivery and transportation method. We would like to make the last mile delivery more efficient by providing the precise tools that are required for inner city rapid last mile delivery.
The explosion of e-commerce is a major reason why urban last mile delivery traffic has been growing significantly in recent years. By 2030, 36% more delivery vehicles are forecast to roam inner city streets globally. Yet last mile delivery is considered one of the least efficient and most polluting processes in a supply chain. Congestion and air pollution caused by last mile transportation are especially bad in densely populated urban areas. More than 300 cities in Europe alone now have low emission zones where fossil fueled vehicles are banned or restricted. Unlike their human counterparts, robo-couriers might one day operate non-stop, thanks to wireless charging during loading or unloading, which Clevon says is being tested. And how does the self-driving technology work? First, the operational area is mapped with teleoperated vehicles, producing a high-precision semantic map. In autonomous mode, the vehicle then uses the map to find the most optimal route. Plus, there are cameras providing a 360-degree field of view, and the front radar and neural networks detect and predict the movement of surrounding objects, on the basis of which the vehicle can slow down to prevent possible accidents. Thanks to 4G, latency is not an issue, Clevon says. Making self-driving mode safe is not the only challenge pioneering unmanned parcel delivery brings about. For one, what happens when recipients don't collect their parcels?
We need to understand what are the possibilities and how the consumers will accept these deliveries, because they are a slightly different approach. They need to come down from your apartment building to get the parcel, so consumers as well need to adapt a little bit. There should be one small urban depot within a city area, and from there, several multiple vehicles are heading out and delivering in city area. And then we are seeing already very good efficiency increase.
Another innovation both DPD and DHL Estonia are currently testing is separating the cargo space so parcels can be delivered to up to 6 individual customers per delivery round, thus increasing efficiency.
We are selling the whole unit together with the top application, which we manufacture in-house as well. And that top application is actually customized to each customer's individual requirements, because the vehicles might have different purposes.
Some Clevon ones deliver packages, which means they need a parcel locker on wheels. Others deliver food items, which requires a grocery-specific refrigerator. Clevon vehicles are limited to 25 kilometers an hour for now. They're still controlled by humans in the background. Each of these so-called teleoperators, who need a Category B driver's license and must first complete a 2-week course, will one day be able to monitor up to 10 vehicles simultaneously. Unlike other autonomous vehicle makers, Clevon is building autonomous driving systems on the basis of teleoperation.
We are saying that 96% autonomy is already enough to make a significant mark and cost reduction and efficiency increase in the last mile delivery space. 96% means that we are still using some level of teleoperation and human touch to allow the fleet of vehicles to be operated on the public roads.
Autonomous vehicles still need to clear major regulatory hurdles on the road to replacing traditional delivery vans. So far, only France and Germany have authorized some level of autonomous driving. An EU-wide regulation could speed things up, but currently it's just a legal framework for the approval of automated and fully driverless vehicles. Aside from DPD and DHL Express Estonia, the hardware and software company has one customer each in Lithuania, Belgium, and the US. Clevon says more than 50 other companies are waiting to test the unmanned robo-couriers. The manufacturer aims to have a fleet of 100 vehicles doing deliveries by the end of 2024 and 1,000 vehicles by 2025. Clevon also plans to build a larger version of its unmanned delivery robot. Furthermore, it envisages a driverless vehicle that can one day transport people. Can unmanned electric vehicles fix the massive problems plaguing last-mile urban delivery?
Less and less vehicles that are driving with petrol are allowed in the city centers. So we see that having an electric, small, efficient vehicle to replace gas-guzzling trucks is where the world is going. Our technology can be deployed globally, potentially. We are actually providing a tool to gradually increase the level of electric efficient trucks on the roads. And it's a continuous process throughout many, many years.
In the meantime, Clevon is striving to make semi-autonomous transportation part and parcel of a sustainable future, one delivery at a time.